Depicting seven saints, they're the only post-medieval frescoes showing human figures to be found on the rock. Rediscovered over 10 years ago during routine works, the frescoes had sat untouched until restoration began last summer.
We are in a Franciscan monastery. Is now the residence of the governor, but obviously its origins are sort of the first Franciscan mission to Gibraltar, which was at the end of the 15th century, just slightly after the conquest of Gibraltar by the Christians. And these frescoes actually represent the Franciscan order in itself in Gibraltar, but also a certain moment in time of the Franciscan order, which is the 1520s, 1530s, when there's the Counter-Reformation in Spain. They're sort of against the Protestantism that spread in Northern Europe, and these frescoes are very much within that sort of time period, in the sense of the Franciscans are retrenching. It's a new puritanical take on the Catholic faith, and these are very much in that image. I mean, they're showing very strong Christian ideology of the 16th century, I hasten to add.
And tell me about the restoration process. How long did it take?
Well, actually, the restoration process took about 6 months in total, from about July till early January. The frescoes were in a very, very frail state. I think if we'd left them much longer, they would have completely collapsed. They were already starting to fail. And the whole point of what we're trying to do here is, one, is to restore and retain, as in to sort of fix it back to the original wall. And then to not to recreate, but to redraw over areas that we know that there must have been painting, so that we have as complete a picture as possible of the original frescoes. Obviously, where the whole parts of the frescoes have disappeared, we don't recreate it. We just do it where we already have some drawing.
The frescoes have really undergone a huge transformation, and Kevin gave us some history on the saints depicted.
So in this case, we have Saint Louis. Is Saint Louis of Toulouse. He was one of the sons of the King of Sicily, and he left all his richly goods. And he was also an heir to the French throne. He left all his richly goods to become a Franciscan monk. The fact that he did this is supremely important, because the fact that a high noble would give all his worldly goods and become a monk really inspired a lot of other Franciscans or wannabe Franciscans to join. In the other panel, you have Saint Francis of Assisi. He's the founder of the order of Franciscans, hence the name. An incredibly important person. He was made a saint within 2 years of his death. So fast tracked into sainthood. He is, as I said, he's the founder of the order. And by the 16th century, the Franciscans were the most important order in Gibraltar and in Spain. It's only later on that the Jesuits take over, but the Franciscans were it. They were top dog at the time.
Fortunately, they're no longer hidden away, and the frescoes are set to be included as part of the convent tour in future, so the public will be able to enjoy the historical Franciscan art for themselves.